Tesla will soon introduce a new LFP home energy storage system. What I mean by that is Tesla will soon be releasing a new and improved version of its very popular home energy storage system, Powerwall. The third version of Powerwall, referred to as Powerwall 3, will be cheaper for Tesla to produce while also offering benefits to owners. If it's cheaper for Tesla to produce, it will be cheaper for you too. While Tesla has not yet officially announced Powerwall 3, the new product first surfaced last year when details of an internal meeting leaked, in which it was revealed a new home energy storage product was in the works. Not much was said about the new product, except that it would allow for easier installations, have improved aesthetics and higher performance than its predecessors. Tesla was intending to pilot the new Powerwall 3 with employees in 2022, and now it looks like the company is preparing for a public launch of the new product. According to a report by Electric, Tesla has begun applying to have Powerwall 3 approved and certified with some utility companies in the United States. The report states that some utility companies have already certified Powerwall 3, meaning a launch of a new product could happen very soon. Now let's talk about the specs of the Powerwall 3. Here are the Powerwall 3 specs. While the application that the Drive Tesla saw didn't reveal the unit specifications, Drive Tesla publication has been able to obtain some information on Powerwall 3. According to their source, one of the biggest changes is on the inside, as the company will switch from using lithium NMC battery cells to prismatic LFP, lithium iron phosphate cells. This will make Powerwall 3 cheaper to produce and follows the same change Tesla made with its utility-scale Megapack system last year and the Model 3 rear-wheel drive before that. Drive Tesla says, we're also told to expect the same 13.5 kilowatt-hour energy capacity as the existing Powerwall 2. However, the new unit will now come with 15.4 kilowatt of peak backup power compared to the 10 kilowatt in the current version. On the outside, Powerwall 3 will look much like Powerwall 2, but it will have a significant smaller form factor than its predecessor. Although the Drive Tesla was not provided with the exact dimensions, they said they did see a photo of the new unit, and while it's only about 5 inches shorter than Powerwall 2, it appears to be about 25% narrower. The unit will be made of die-cast aluminum and feature no adhesives sealing, with Tesla instead using weld sealing for the Powerwall 3 enclosure. Drive Tesla says, we can't share the photo we were provided, but here is a general approximation of the size of Powerwall 3 compared to Powerwall 2. Sadly, we don't have any information on how Powerwall 3 pricing will compare to Powerwall 2. Currently, Powerwall 2 sells for $9,200 for a single unit, $17,200 for two units, and $25,000 for three units. Tesla recently started taking orders for Powerwall again without requiring it to be bundled with a solar purchase at the same time. Earlier, Tesla required a bundle with solar purchase, but now Tesla does not require that. The good news is that Tesla is going to be using LFP battery cells in the Powerwall. That means because LFP is cheaper to make, iron is widely available, and hopefully Tesla will lower the prices of Powerwall 3. Remember these words: once Powerwall 3 is available, it may be lower than the current prices. So we'll look forward to that. Big news about Tesla Semi. PepsiCo unveils 21 Tesla Semi trucks at its Sacramento bottling plant. PepsiCo has revealed its all-electric fleet comprising 21 Tesla Semis. The electric trucks will operate out of its Sacramento bottling plant. With this, the company has cemented its place in the truck's history as the first to take delivery. 21 Tesla Semis at PepsiCo. The trucks will be used to deliver PepsiCo products locally. This differs from the 15 units the company uses at its Frito-Lay manufacturing plant in Modesto, as reported by the Sacramento Bee. PepsiCo was among the first companies to register interest in the Tesla Semi truck when it was revealed in 2017. However, it was assisted in the procurement by state and federal grants. For example, PepsiCo received $4.5 million from the Sacramento Metropolitan Air Quality Management District, which paid for 18 out of the 21 trucks. PepsiCo has an order for 100 semi-trucks from Tesla, with some of them meant for long-haul deliveries in California. The trucks can last 400 miles between charges, each costing about $250,000. Tesla can expect more orders from California companies as the state's Air Resources Board is making a rule requiring all new trucks to be electric by 2045. The semis will be charged by four 750 kilowatt-hour chargers at Sacramento and Modesto. So 2045, the year California will require all new semi-trucks to be electric. Imagine the opportunities that this will open for Tesla and for Tesla semi sales. But also this will push many other truck makers and car makers to speed up their efforts to build more electric trucks and build more truck electric semi-trucks. So expect for more electric semi-trucks to see in California roads, and also that will become a trend, and in the United States we will see more electric semi-trucks, which is great for our air. So PepsiCo is unveiling 21 Tesla semi-trucks, and it's good news for our big cities. I mean, imagine the last time you have had very fresh air in your cities. But thank God, it looks like, by the blessing of God, we're moving to that direction now. Tesla Giga Berlin is helping to develop the Brandenburg success story, says the state's economic minister, Jörg Steinbach. He says it's true that the state is benefiting from this. The Tesla effect is real, he says. So let's take a look what effect he talks about. Tesla started production in Germany at Giga Berlin just over a year ago, but is already making a big positive impact on the state of Brandenburg, where it is located. In the long term, Giga Berlin should produce 1 million electric vehicles per year and battery cells for Tesla's cars. Local politicians recognize that the arrival and activity of Tesla contribute to the positive growth of the economy of the federal state. Here's a quote for you. Yes, Brandenburg is gaining momentum. Brandenburg Minister of Economics Jörg Steinbach, a big Tesla supporter, told Tagesspiegel. He says, this is real turning point that proves the economic and therefore social success of this state. He also said, now the state is clearly catching up in important economic key data compared to the Western federal states, he added. In terms of economic growth, Brandenburg overtook even the strong federal states for the first time last year, together with Bavaria and Baden-Württemberg. According to federal and state statistics, the federal state posted the strongest gross domestic product, the GDP growth, of any non-city states at 3.3%. GDP growth was about twice the national average, 1.8%. Steinbach said that the manufacturing industry, especially the automotive sector, is the driver, quote-unquote driver, of this growth. He said, behind this is also the launch of Tesla production in Grünheide. It is true that the country benefits from this. The Tesla effect is real, he said. Brandenburg's manufacturing sector grew by 13.4%, according to the Tagesspiegel, despite soaring energy prices and continued supply chain restrictions. It was the highest growth rate in the entire country, in Germany. Now, Tesla is currently ramping up production at its first European factory, Giga Berlin, in the municipality of Grünheide, which is just outside Berlin, I think 15 minutes or so away. At the end of March, the company announced that it had reached production of 5,000 electric vehicles a week there at Giga Berlin. For phase one, the goal is to produce 500,000 vehicles per year. At the moment, Tesla Giga Berlin has reached a production capacity of about 250,000 vehicles per year. For phase one, 12,000 employees are planned to work at Giga Berlin, and as of March, there were more than 10,000 people working at Giga Berlin. Tesla is the largest private employer in the region. In the next phase of Giga Berlin of expansion, Giga Berlin aims to produce another 500,000 vehicles. This means the total production capacity of the factory will reach 1 million electric vehicles per year. Thanks to this expansion, Brandenburg will be able to develop even further, steadily occupying the position of one of the fastest growing states in Germany. Now, keep in mind that Brandenburg is in eastern Germany, which used to be under Soviet influence before the unification or reunification of Germany. And eastern states were usually considered to be economically lagging behind the western states, like Bavaria. But now, like I said, according to this report that I just presented to you, Brandenburg for the first time is ahead of Bavaria, which is wonderful in terms of gross domestic product, GDP. So this is the real impact Tesla Giga Berlin is having on Germany, on German economy, and on the economy of Brandenburg. Thanks for watching, everyone. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you found these reports interesting, please give us thumbs up and like this video and subscribe to our channel. Also, ring the bell after you subscribe so you don't miss my next coverage. And also, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. God bless you and your families. Have a great day. I'll see you soon in our next report.